In Microsoft Excel, many times you may require to add more data to your current worksheet by adding new columns, rows, and even cells. So in Excel terms, we call it inserting columns, rows, and cells. Not only that, but many times you may also need to delete columns and rows. So in this tutorial, you will learn how to insert and delete columns, rows, and cells in an Excel worksheet. In this Excel worksheet, I need to insert a student roll number column after the student name. So, to do this, I select the column B by left-clicking on its heading. You can insert sheet columns and rows in many different ways, and every time you insert a new column, it is inserted left to the selected column. Now to insert a new column, from the Home tab click Insert drop-down menu, under Cells section, and then click Insert Sheet Columns. Do you have a new column inserted left, and your current data is automatically shifted to the right? Now here I can add the student roll number. The other method that you can use to insert a new column is to use right-click context menu command. Let's say I need a blank column between the subjects, English and physics, and for this I need to insert a new column after column G, and before column H. So the other approach to insert a new column is to directly right-click on column H, and then click Insert from the context menu. So it is up to you that which method you find easiest to use. Other times, you also might want to remove some extra columns from your worksheet. For instance, in this particular worksheet, I don't need that 30% column under subject English. So to remove this column, you can either select this column first, and then click Delete in Cells section from the Home tab, and then click Delete Sheet Columns. Or you can right-click on the column in question, and then click Delete from the context menu. When you delete a column, the data to the right is automatically shifted to the left. Same as columns, you can also insert new rows between your current data. For instance, I need to enter a new student name between John and James. Do note that, when you insert a new row, it is inserted upward to the selected row. So here I need a new row after John and before James. So I select James, and then click Insert Sheet Rows from the Cells section under Home tab. You can also insert a new row by directly right-clicking on the row number, where you need a new row, and then click Insert from the context menu. To remove an entire row, you can either right-click on the row and then click Delete from the context menu, or you can click on Delete from the Cells section, and then click Delete Sheet Rows. So you always have two very common and easy ways for inserting and deleting sheet columns and rows, and it is up to you that which one you prefer the most, or use both methods now and then. Lastly, we have the option from inserting and removing cells. Cell or cells are referred to as an intersection of a column and row. It is important to understand the concept of inserting and removing cells from the sheet, instead of inserting or removing an entire column or row. While rechecking the data of this worksheet, I find out that, by mistake, I fill the marks of student name Smiley in the row of student name Lovely, and I actually forget to fill the marks of Lovely. The data to the left and right side are fine. So I don't need a complete new row here. What I need here is to insert 5 new cells, and shift these 5 values down. To do this, I first select these 5 cells, then either right-click on them and choose Insert. Or I can click Insert Cells from the Cells section under Home tab. Then I will prompt it with 4 options, like do I want to insert a new column or row, or insert new cells and shift the currently selected cells to either down or right side. As I want to insert new cells only and want to shift the currently selected cells to down, so I choose the second option and hit OK. You can see that the data in the left and right cells of the selected cells will remain intact. You can also do the opposite by using the Delete Cells command. Let's say that you want to delete all the empty cells for student name Lovely, under the subject Physics, and move the bottom values to upward. So select these cells, then right-click and choose Delete. From the Delete dialog box, select Shift Cells Up and press OK. Sometimes, you also might want to insert or remove more than one columns or rows in a time. When you use Insert Column or Insert Row command, Excel automatically inserted those number of columns or rows, equals to selected columns or rows. For instance, if I select two columns and then use the Insert Sheet Columns command, then two new columns will be inserted, and that also applies to the rows as well. Using the same method, you can also delete more than one column or row at once. You can also insert new columns, rows, or even cells using a keyboard shortcut, and the shortcut key is Ctrl and plus sign from numeric keypad. If a column or row is already selected, and you press Ctrl plus, then it will automatically insert a new column or row according to selection, without prompting anything. But if you press Ctrl plus without selecting anything, then insert dialog box appear, and you can then make a choice. To remove column, row, or cells, you can use Ctrl minus sign from numeric keypad. The procedure we just followed was to insert or remove one or more columns or rows in a series. But what if you need to insert or remove multiple columns or rows in a non-continuous fashion? For this, you need to make a non-continuous selection first, and to do this, select the first column or row, then hold down the Ctrl key, while clicking and selecting other columns. Now if you will use Insert Sheet Columns command, a new column will be inserted after each selected column. Or you can also use Delete Sheet Columns to remove multiple non-continuous columns at once. The same procedure goes for the sheet rows as well. So this was all about inserting a single or multiple columns, rows, or cells into your worksheet. If you found this video useful, then don't forget to hit the thumbs up, and do share this video with your friends. Leave us a comment in the box below, and subscribe to our channel for more upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and take good care of yourself.